Hi, today's question is by Hariyara. Question is it advisable to solve theta questions as there are no negative marks? I rarely advise people to focus on theta and non-theta. Only when maybe a person is getting negative marks should he look at theta questions so that he doesn't, in a sense, get negative if he goes wrong. The only place where I may advise people on theta is in the verbal section. Okay, where maybe odd man out, even if you go wrong, you don't get negative marks. Other places you can go negative marks. That's the only place I would recommend theta questions. Else I don't recommend theta questions because getting an answer to theta question is comparatively difficult as compared to a normal question. For example, in maths, theta question can have any number of answers, but if you have options, you have only four options which are possible answers. So I normally tell people don't classify as theta or non-theta. Classify the questions as, are they easy or not easy? Let's be very clear with that. I mean, if they're easy questions, whether it is theta or non-theta, solve it. If it's not the easy questions, then leave it. You want, you can have one number saying that I'll put all theta questions 0, 1. You can do that. But no point solving it just because of theta question. That is a wrong strategy. Solve it only because the question is easy. Leave it only because the question is tough. Nothing to do with a theta or a non-theta question. I don't think that should be a parameter of selecting a question to be solved in the examination. Clear? So next time when you solve a mock, ensure that you classify it as easy. A lot of people also classify based on topic. Sometimes it's okay to classify on topic. Okay, specifically if you're not very good at very specific topics, then maybe. But even then, I normally prefer people classifying it as easy or tough. I'll give you an example. I had a student who had gone to the examination, good student. He classified, okay, these are questions I'll solve first, and if I don't understand that, I'll then go to other topics. So he was very good in very few specific topics which he had done really well. So he started picking up those questions and solving it. But he realized that when he was solving, it was tougher question, it took a longer time for him to solve. By the time he finished those questions and went to the other questions, which he said I'll do in the second round because those topics I was not comfortable with, he realized that those questions were easier and he could have solved faster. But unfortunately, he didn't have enough time and therefore he couldn't complete those questions. He said that because of that, his scores dipped. I mean, he would have actually got more answers if he had directly solved, picked up easy questions and left out difficult questions. But because he tried to select questions based on topic, ended up solving difficult questions in the examination and missed out on the easy questions. So therefore, whenever you classify, try and focus on classifying based on easy and tough and not on anything else, not on topics, not on theta, non-theta, etc. Read questions, takes 10 seconds to read a question and then decide within 5. So within 15 seconds, you should be able to classify how the question is and then go ahead. Right? I hope that is clear. Thank you.